a wonderful hike in Headwaters Reserve, Elk River Trail, California. This is a John's Travel Adventures production. This area is quite notable by how it was acquired. It was originally owned by the Pacific Lumber Company. A hostile takeover from someone out of the area paid over $600 million for the entire company and all the redwoods. They wanted to pay for it by cutting the trees down at a rapid rate to generate revenue. A lot of people were very unhappy with that. Environmentalists managed to sneak into the private property and take lots of pictures of what was here. So they generated a whole movement, even someone that became a state congressperson to save this area. But since it was owned by someone else privately, they had to come up with money. The state and the federal government together came up with an offer of $480 million, which is most of what he paid for the entire company. And of course, he turned it down and wanted more. But in the last minute, he accepted that. So for $480 million, they were able to save this area. And you can see a lot of it. There's some parts we didn't quite get to. Some mushrooms are edible and some are not. They can be poisonous. I don't know the difference, so I leave them alone. And I like leaving things alone in nature and not tearing it all apart. A banana slug. Then there's a snake along the trail. To get there going south, take the first freeway exit after Eureka and turn left and follow the signs. There's a nice parking area and restrooms and things. The first mile of the trail is paved. After that, it turns to gravel, and then it eventually turns to a narrower trail. The local newspaper covered the purchase of Headwaters.
You need to go to Corpus Christi, the three of us, so have fun. It's so beautiful there. It's nice here. Yeah,
I wasn't expecting the sound of chainsaws on our hike, but they're clearing a side trail and making spawning habitat for salmon fish along the creek. About a mile in the trail is where the town of Falk used to be. It was a timber town, many buildings, dentists, doctors, people working there with steam-powered things to move the lumber before they had even larger vehicles. They closed this down by 1937, and then they destroyed the building so people wouldn't be getting in there and getting it hurt or injured or so, and let it go back to nature. On a side trail, these are artifacts left from the timber era. This is more of the side trail we explored before we got back to the main trail. We went to the bridge. We're back on the main trail now. It's not paved forever. And if you're wondering why there are not a lot of big old growth trees everywhere, well, we were by the town of Falk that was a timber town, so they cut all the trees nearby that they could. And gradually trees grew back. The Headwaters old growth forest is further ahead. If you haven't yet, please hit the subscribe button. Hitting the bell to be notified is good also. In fact, hitting the like button is appreciated. And if you have any comments, please leave them below. This is the bridge that's just a little over 3 miles in on the hike. After that bridge, we do a lot more steep uphill. We climb about 750 to 800 feet elevation in the next mile or so. This is the 4 mile bridge, a little bridge at 4 miles. And we went a little ways further, and then we realized if we were going to get out in daylight, we should probably turn around. And we did miss, the trail goes up 5 miles. At 5 miles, there's a half mile loop that goes through old growth forest. We'll have to leave earlier if we want to do that and come back another time. We just didn't want to be hiking out in the dark. We didn't know how long this was going to take.
Thank you. na lagi ning irison ni ako ang gidi pa. Wa matarong. Natuwad.
Natuwad ya.
Pagkuan ni Jan.
Isen ko ang gidi.
Thank you for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this video.